Hello everyone. One night, a house caught fire and a young boy was forced to flee to the roof. The father stood on the ground below with the outstretched arms, calling to his son, "Jump, my son, I will catch you." He knew the boy had to jump to save his life. All the boy could see, however, was flame, smoke, and blackness. As can be imagined, he was afraid to leave the roof. His father kept yelling, "Jump, my son, I will catch you." The boy protested, "Dad, I can't see you." The father replied, "But I can see you, and that's all that matters." The boy, eventually trusting in the father, jumped and landed safely in his father's arms. Friends, there are many great examples in the Bible of people who had strong faith in God. To them, God was the center of their focus, and God's promise mattered the most. They had learned to put their complete and total trust in God's wisdom and power. They recognized their complete reliance on God. The 11th chapter of the letter to the Hebrews is one of the best known of the chapters of the Bible, which talks about people who had accomplished great things through faith and obedience. The writer cites the example of the faith of Abel, the brother of Cain, Enoch, the great-grandfather of Noah, and one of the two people in the Bible taken up to heaven without dying, Noah, who was regarded as the most righteous and blameless man among the people of his time, Abraham, who is called the father of the Jewish nation, Sarah, the wife of Abraham, who is called the mother of the Jewish nation, Isaac, the miracle child of Abraham and Sarah, Jacob, the father of the 12 tribes of Israel, Joseph, the interpreter of dreams, Moses, the giver of the law of God, and Joshua, who was regarded as one of the most successful leaders of all the ancient Jewish leaders after Moses. Although they were long dead, the writer used the exemplary faith of the ancestors to encourage and challenge the faith of the persecuted Jewish Christians. Among all the biblical patriarchs, Abraham is extolled the father of all who believe, for the reason that he reveals the totality of a faith life. We all know quite well the story of Abraham as described in the book of Genesis from chapter 12 to 25. When God wanted to liberate humankind from sin, he looked around the earth and found Abraham the most righteous man and so chose him to lead the people. He was righteous not because he was a holy man, but because he was a man of faith. In today's text, the writer points out how Abraham expressed a real life of faith. 1. Abraham's journey of faith. The writer says, "By faith Abraham obeyed when he was called to go out to a place that he was to receive an inheritance. He went out, not knowing where he was to go." For Abraham, the journey of faith began on the day when God called him to leave his home and go wherever God would lead him. It must have been hard for him to leave his birthplace, his home, his land, family, and ties, and abandon all of his present status for an uncertain future, but he did. It was an instant kind of immediate obedience. He was so obedient that he did not even think about where he was going. The place where he was going was immaterial. What mattered to him the most was God's promise to bless him and his descendants forever. Abraham demonstrated his worthiness by his faithfulness till the end. 2. Abraham's power of faith. The writer says, "By faith he received power to generate, even though he was past the normal age, and Sarah herself was sterile, for thought that the one who had made the promise was trustworthy." When the messengers of God told Abraham that they would have a child, Sarah laughed. So did Abraham. They both thought they were too old to have children, but God blessed them with a child anyway. Abraham even had children after Sarah died. Abraham's faith was so powerful that even though he knew how impossible the situation was, he believed that the one who had made the promise would accomplish the impossible. His powerful demonstration of faith made it possible for him to have a son even in his old age. 3. Abraham's proof of faith. The writer says, "By faith, Abraham, when put to the test, offered up Isaac, and he who had received the promises was ready to offer his only son." The real test of Abraham's faith came, therefore, when God asked him to offer his only son, Isaac, to him as a sacrifice. Abraham did as he was commanded, believing in the power of God to bring him to life, even if he was dead. Pleased with Abraham's unflinching faith, God spared Isaac by providing Abraham a lamb for the sacrifice. God did what he had promised to Abraham. Friends, like Abraham, we are also being called by God to have a clear and obedient faith in him. Our faith journey began at baptism and continues to grow in faith in the God who is faithful. Our faith requires us not only to be convinced that there is God, or to declare that we believe in God, and that He is among us through the birth of His only begotten Son, Jesus Christ. It also requires us not just to carry out some rituals to express our faith, but also to act according to faith values and make decisions inspired by faith, even in the midst of hardships, difficulties, and distress. Our faith often requires us to forsake things, people, places, interests, attitudes, and values closest to us in order for us to inherit God's promises of hope, peace, joy, and love. Our faith requires us to have faith powerful enough to even move mountains. Our faith requires us to look to God for strength and trust that He will provide for us. As we celebrate the feast of the Holy Family of Jesus, Mary, and Joseph, let us, as individuals and families, surrender ourselves to our faithful God and ask Him to strengthen in us the gift of obedient faith like Abraham. Amen. God bless you.